We're back for another vintage toy restoration. Today we have this Rubberface bunny, unsure of the brand. Evidently, she's been very loved over the years. You can see a lot of holes, a lot of dirt, and the ears are just filthy. First step always is to pop the seams. Just opened her up, and as you can see, she is filled with foam. If you guys watch Cole at Kitschy Flower, he explains how the foam literally gets everywhere, and he wasn't lying. Here she is, all flat and unstuffed, and now it's time for a bath. Always use lukewarm to cold water. It's important for the fur and the colors, and I just mix a little bit of detergent and hand soap. She did have a lot of visible dirt on her fur, so I did end up having to change out the water about 2 or 3 times. Here she is out of her bath, and I'm so happy with how her color came out. It's so much brighter. Always remember not to put your vintage plush in the dryer. If you want to speed up the process like me, I just use a hairdryer on the cold setting. It's very important. I decided to remove this silk material from the ears because it was still dirty and there's a lot of holes. It was just probably not worth it to sew. So basically what I'm doing here is just measuring out roughly the inches of the ear hole, and then I'm just freehanding the shape onto a piece of paper to make a little pattern. I had 2 options here. I had this like fun flower fabric, and then I just had white felt, and I'm just trying to decide which one I want. I of course went with this fabric. It does match with the eyes, so I thought it would be a cute touch. I just traced on both sides and then I just cut it out. One ear done. And here she is. I'm very proud of myself for this, even if it wasn't the best job. I'm usually not a sewer, so. Here you can see me just restuffing her. I'm using a mix of my old Rushton stuffing from my tubby bear and the foam. The last step, of course, is the face paint. I'm just touching everything up a little bit.